Hey guys.
Hi. Trying to figure out what to do.
It is Saturday. Oh, Tom just invited me to something.
Ooh.
So it's Saturday. We survived the night.
Yeah.
The room was good. You saw the room. The bed was actually quite comfortable. I was kind of impressed.
I don't know.
I mean, it was a little firmer for
my case. The pillows were weird. They give you like 8 pillows, but they were all like maybe a half a pillow each, if even so.
Yeah, they were a little bit smaller than standard size pillows, which was a little weird. But but we just checked out, as much as you check out from hotels nowadays.
We checked out, not like that, but like out of the hotel.
Yeah, out of the hotel. We've dropped the keys. We're in 2 minutes, we will not have a room anymore.
And he's wearing his Yotuma shirt.
I'm wearing my new Yotuma shirt.
And I'm wearing my new Pursuit shirt.
And she's wearing her new Pursuit shirt.
Which has awesome Pursuit on the sleeve.
Which
even.
I did not even notice.
Which I saw it.
She saw. Because she's more observant sometimes.
Sometimes.
So yeah, now we're just in the car and trying to figure out
what to do on a 59 degree day.
What to do on a 59 degree day.
Yeah.
56 degree day.
Well, when I only packed like shorts and some dresses.
She was not prepared for the weather. Well, that's okay. We'll figure it out.
I mean, if I get desperate,
I was going to say, worst comes to worst, we'll just stop somewhere and get you some jeans.
Yeah.
But we do have brewery options, because we do have that growler to fill at some point. And since we're here, we might as well.
Yep.
And again, I'd like to swing by at least Castle Danger.
Yes. Yep.
And then we also have, well, we have that $10 ice cream that you could get, but I don't see ice cream being...
Well, who says it has to be ice cream? Maybe they sell coffee or something too. But well, we could always save it for later.
Oh, we could save it.
It's, you know, it's good. And then he hasn't been to a zoo in a long time, and he's never been to the Lake Superior Zoo.
I didn't even know Lake Superior had a zoo.
It's not as awesome when I went a couple years ago. It's not as awesome as it was like back in maybe mid-2000s, before it had a big flood. They had like a huge flood down that area, and they redid it, but it's not as cool as it used to be, at least not from my memory. But we could go do that today too and check
that out. We could just kind of bum around,
do whatever,
bum around Duluth, which again is you know, one of our favorite towns, so we have no problem just killing time here. We know how to do that. We're very good at that.
My parents taught me to do that.
Yeah,
never bored.
Never bored.
Always find something to do.
Especially if you find us in a record store or an antique store.
Yep. There is still that antique store if we get so bored. There's probably a million more around the area too.
I was gonna say. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that's what we're doing.
Yeah,
breakfast. Breakfast is surprisingly good.
For
a continental, like, kind of cheap hotel breakfast, I thought it was fairly good.
It was a little disappointing. They ran out of milk, and then they ran out of pancake waffle batter. Which I didn't need any waffle batter, but it's just kind of like, well, you know, there was still an hour, well, close to an hour left for breakfast.
Yeah, when we got down there,
running out of stuff, so. But I suppose I didn't want to open a whole another bag for, you think that they could refrigerate that.
Yeah, I don't know how that
for a day.
Yeah, you know? I'm not sure.
But anyways, whatever their policy is, but he didn't want to open another one or anything, so.
Yeah, the one poor guy who had a bowl of cereal and had to literally, like, open the machine and squeeze, like, the last bit of milk out of the bag to...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's like,
I would be like, let's run over to the gas station and get a gallon of milk for these poor people, but I suppose that's what it is.
Yeah, I'm sure there's some sort of, like, health concern or some sort of policy or something that...
I don't know.
Even though in other smaller hotels we've been in, they've literally done that.
Yeah.
So it's like, you know.
Yeah, it's, you know, I don't know. But it's all right. It's whatever. But it just was like, oh, dude, that sucks for that guy.
Just put a big tape X over the cereal unless you want to dry. Something like that.
Which I thought about for Frosted Flakes, because the Raisin Bran. Because I like Raisin Bran dry. That's occasionally. I actually wanted it with milk today, but I couldn't get the milk thing to work for my coffee, so I didn't think it was going to work for my cereal. And then the guy said it was...
If you got really desperate, you could just take a bunch of the creamers and...
No, not that desperate.
No, no?
I've done such a thing maybe when I was a kid, but no, thank you.
The worst I've ever done as a kid, and this is when I was like, six, seven probably, it was cornflakes, because we just didn't have a lot of like sweet stuff in the house when I was growing up for some reason.
Mm-hmm.
And it was Frosted Flakes and the like gallon of fruit punch you could get for like 50 cents.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
As a kid, it tasted fine. But...
Yeah. I mean, I suppose it works, but not my preferred.
Yeah, that's probably the hottest one I've done.
Funny. Well, we shan't do that today.
No, not today. We'll
have to find good beer and other things.
Yes.
And zoos and... Oh, and the lighthouse.
Remember the lighthouse that her coworker told her about, which is in Superior, right? Where's it?
I think she said it's Superior. Okay. It's Wisconsin Point Lighthouse or something like that. So,
Yeah. If we get there, we'll let you know.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah. So.
Yep.
Oh, is it an IPA? It
tastes like it. Yeah.
Okay, so here we are. We're at. Can't see the sign, but we're at Castle Danger.
Mm-hmm.
And we have our flight. So we have, what's that, the sea salt and lime?
Sea salt lime. Honey wheat, honey raspberry wheat.
Something crush.
Summer crush.
And then that one, which you just tried, which looked really good because all the fruits in it.
Yeah.
But if it's an IPA, then I don't know.
It might be just a sour.
It might be a sour. And then we have, this is the orange cream ale, which is a limited run, so we had to get it since we're up here. And this guy is an apple blonde. Apple blonde ale.
Which I didn't even see this, so I'm glad you mentioned it. So.
Yeah, so let's see, how do we...
Well, you could do the tasting. Do you want me to hold the phone and do the tasting? You tell me if I'm holding it good.
Yeah, how do we?
Yep, all right.
Now, if they can hear, that's a different question, because this is, it's way busier now than it was last time.
Yeah.
Okay, this is your cream. I know it like this. That is good stuff.
That's your favorite, the orange cream.
Orange cream. And these guys we got. these two we got with the craft taps. Our first craft taps.
BOGO. Yeah.
And we get 10 beers a month.
Each.
So we get 20 beers a month between the two of us. It's insane.
Yeah. We got there with our fundraiser.
With our fundraiser.
Thing.
Yeah. Don't watch that video. So we have a whole flight and 2 pints to get through. So that's very hazy.
It's pretty.
That's apple long. Ale. It's harder than you would expect.
Oh, yeah?
But, yeah. Then we'll go in this way, because I think this one's going to be going. I think this is the line that's going to be going. This guy.
Tell me if I'm holding it good still.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yeah, that is very not creative. And I'm doing that of the pineapple, a little bit of orange, but none of the pineapple or the passion fruit, whatever else is supposed to be in there, I'm really getting none of that. You're getting the orange in like that almost bitter, like blood orange.
Yes. Uh huh.
Okay. So
this is a summer crush, light.
So it's kind of like a shandy.
And there's a train going by, so I'm distracted because I love trains. So.
Whoa. Okay, it's a little bitter, but that's actually really good. Like that is like fresh.
That is a good like lemon shandy kind of deal. Oh, that's good.
Yeah, that might be better than limey candy.
Very lemon zesty.
Yeah, that's like fresh. Yes. If you like fresh lemon, that's definitely where.
Yeah.
The raspberry. And you can, it just smells sweet.
Honey raspberry. Yep.
Oh. That's good too. And again, yeah. it, you get that like fresh raspberry.
Look how pretty it is too. That's just too. A really pretty, pretty kind of color. Yeah, there we go.
Yeah.
You gotta tell me if I'm not holding
it. It's almost like a pink. Yeah. Very nice. Okay, now this is the one. Yeah, get that in here.
Oh, it smells good.
Yeah, it smells sweeter than it is, but it's actually really good. Again, you get that like fresh raspberry.
That's my favorite so far, the ones I tasted, of the flight.
Okay, now here we go.
Sea salt lime. You like it.
It tastes like the old frozen concentrate wine.
Ooh.
That is good.
Let me try that one. Oh, that smells, it almost smells like a lemon house cleaner. Mm-hmm. Or lemon air freshener.
Yeah, something like that.
I mean lime air freshener. Ooh. Bacardi used to make, maybe still does, a margarita, lime margarita mixer in the frozen concentrate.
Oh, yeah.
That's
yeah.
what that tastes
I,
like.
I was going to say, throw a shot of tequila in that.
And yep. Oh, geez.
That's a fun day at the
I like
right
that
there.
Idea. Yeah. Yep. So, yeah. I'll give you that back.
We're in the corner. We're always in the corner.
We're always in the corner. Yeah, so do you any other tasty notes you want to?
I have a Chinese.
Try the apple.
This is the apple.
I gotta be careful so I don't get my mustache in that. That's really subtle.
Yeah, it's very subtle.
Barely tastes anything.
Yeah.
It's refreshing. I'm gonna go down just a little. There we go. And the orange cream is still the very best. So my favorite is the orange cream and the honey ras and then the sea salt lime. To get, like, probably even with the honey ras and the sea salt lime. And then the orange cream is good. A little bitter still to me.
Yeah.
But and then this just is, this doesn't taste like really the apple. It just tastes like just refreshing.
Yeah, it's very subtle with the apple flavor. Yeah.
So, I mean, they're all good.
They're all quite good. Yeah.
Yeah, the summer crush is freaking good too because it's that lemon. Okay, I like this one too. Actually.
Yeah, because it's that like really really fresh lemon. Yeah.
It smells almost like lemon drop candy.
That's what I was going for. Yeah.
It's like a less sweet. Liquid lemon drop.
Yeah, it's a lemon drop once you suck all the sugar off.
I'll be finding that one in the store for sure.
Yeah.
For sure. If they have it in the store.
If they have it.
Yeah, so.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
So.
Got a lot of beer to drink.
Got a lot of beer to drink. So this is stop number one. And we'll just kind of see where the day takes us. It's a little chilly. It's a little rainy. So I don't know. We may still do the zoo. I don't know.
We'll see.
That's okay. But yeah, so that's stop number one. Yeah.
Not cold.
Yeah, that happens. So here we are. So we left Castle Danger after consuming about a half a gallon of beer, which is all delicious, by the way. Highly recommended if you're in the area. Definitely swing by Castle Danger. And we stumbled across the Two Harbors Navigation Project, which has
Those are the Ordocks, I believe.
We believe those are the Ordocks.
And then this is breakwater.
And then this is the breakwater. And I think we're gonna head down.
And then that's the Two Harbors Lighthouse up there.
Yeah.
A little walking in the mist.
In the mist, because it is raining a little bit. A little bit. That's okay. Mm. So this is
Two Harbors.
Two Harbors, which is an awesome little town.
This is just down the road from Castle Danger. So if you go down and you just take a left and you go past, there's like a little train museum actually down there. Little train depot museum, and then you just keep on going and then you run into this. So yeah, which I knew the lighthouse was down here, but I haven't seen this before. Mm-hmm. So yeah.
Yeah, so we're gonna go explore a little bit. So of the big pier thing.
Hi, I'm taking a video too.
There, now I'm videoing. But yeah, outside of the weather being a little temperamental, it's not bad. You got a good view of the
Ordocks?
Ordocks. And we saw a couple trains, or a train.
Big, long, heavy, slow. A big, long train.
And then the ore being deposited from the big piles onto the kind of cool. Yeah. Dealy thingy, signal thing, at the end of this very, very long concrete pier. Mm-hmm. And this one is now freezing. So that's okay.
I'm not smart.
But.
What did I say? I know you mean well and I know you're smart, so why don't I just listen to you? Because I'm stubborn.
So our next stop is to get this one, so pants.
And back to evict the beer.
And to evict the beer, yes, because beer is catching up. But yeah, so the kind of stuff you can see in Duluth, or Two Harbors, technically we're in Two Harbors. But I mean, this view is just awesome. On the shores. Actually, technically, we're not even on the shores. We're in Lake Superior at this point. But yeah, it's just, you know.
And the waves.
It's very, very calming, very, very relaxing. A little cold, but, you know, we will deal. So. So we were heading to Holiday to get gas and use the restroom. You found the porta potties back there. Huh? Little beach. Marker here. Apparently this is Burlington at one point. Who knew? But yeah, nice little dark sand beach, some rocks. Of course it's still freezing out, but that's okay. Got nice big pieces of drifter there. Sure. porta potties in the road. The campground across the street, but that's okay.
It served our purpose.
Yeah. So again, just not necessarily just in Duluth, but wherever you are, just explore. Just go out and see what's out there. Huh? Yeah. You know? Okay, so we stopped for lunch at Blackwoods Bar and Grill. I got the fish because we're up north and Lake Superior. After she got the prime rib, which I am not a big meat person, but that looks awesome. So yeah, we'll tell you how it goes. Okay, so.
Oh, you have it the right way? Okay, there we go.
Well, we'll turn it around at the end. So we're at probably
Cold Press Black. I know I've had the Cold Press.
Yeah, which seems to be kind of what they're known for. So we got a flight. We got three dark ones and one ale.
Yep. Mexican ale.
So,
all right.
Dive right in.
You go do your hair. I'm going to do this.
Okay.
For you.
So this is the
Mexican El Lago.
El Lago. Yep, which tastes very much just like Mexican ale.
All right.
Okay, so that's
the black ale, quarter stout.
Which again, I'm becoming more and more accustomed to.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of interesting.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So then,
Towering Pines.
Towering Pines, which is, what did they say this was?
I don't have you.
Something
it's fine.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Tastes very similar to the black, not as quite as bitter though.
Okay.
A bit smoother. And this one should be interesting. It's the Campfire, which has the marshmallow and the chocolate and all that fun stuff.
Okay.
Oh. It smells like a Hershey's Kiss.
Ooh, that smells good. You like it.
Yeah, it's fine.
I know you do.
Of these four, that's definitely
one. That's your favorite?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
All right. My turn? All right. Don't slide it because I don't want to wear it.
Yeah, you don't want to wear it.
Okay. So,
okay.
I'll lock on. A little IPA-ish.
Just a hair.
All right. Very smoky.
Okay.
The black stout is a very smoky.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
not as smoky, more just basic but strong.
Yeah, a little bit smoother, not quite as bitter, but yeah, does definitely.
The campfire.
Oh,
it smells like a s'mores.
Mm-hmm. And it tastes like hot chocolate.
That might be going in there.
That might be the growler. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
That's my favorite. That's probably my favorite. Mm-hmm. And then maybe actually the black. I like the smoke. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that's pretty good.
Yes.
Yep. All right. Coming to the dark side.
They are turning me to the dark side. So yeah, that's where we're at. We're going to finish these up. We're going to pick one of these. Probably to go on the growl. It's going to be the campfire. If we can get a growler campfire.
Oh, I'm sure.
Assuming we can.
Yeah.
And then, then probably head on home.
Head towards home because it's a couple hours, 2.5 hours home. So, mm-hmm. Yep. And I'll have to get gas. So,
and then, we'll stop and get gas and probably get
Coffee.
Get coffee for this one.
Yep.
Coffee. Mm-hmm. So that's a quick trip up north, but a good trip.
Yeah.
We saw a good show, had a lot of good beers, talked to some really nice people.
Oh, yeah.
The one that we met at the gift shop, we'll talk about that later.
Oh, very nice. And my pretty new bracelet. Handmade up here, so, yeah.
Very, very cool. So, yeah.
Cool.
Anything else?
Beer
for now.
And coffee.
Beer, coffee.
Yep.
Beer and coffee. Yeah. Hey guys.
We made it.
We survived.
Barely.
So we had lunch. It was lunch. It was
okay. It's not as good as I've heard that Blackwoods is. Can be. I've had the Duluth say before with my sister, and we weren't as impressed as we had expected to be. And then now this was the one in Two Harbors, and still not as impressed as I felt like we should be. Service was okay. I mean, nothing phenomenal. The food was decent.
Food was okay.
Phenomenal.
The mashed potatoes were damn good.
The mashed potatoes were delicious, and on my prime rib, I thought they'd give you like that half a head sliced in half roasted garlic, and that was delicious. But the bun, to me, my bun seemed stale and bland. And
it was a little dry. Yeah.
My coffee stunk. The hotel coffee this morning at the breakfast was better than that coffee.
That's saying something. I mean, my fish was good. It was, well cooked, and obviously was, fish out of Lake Superior, so we knew it was fresh. It was prepared well. It was tasty. It wasn't, as I was saying, not the best fish I've had, not the worst fish I've had, The potatoes that came in my dish were interesting. Because they were pretty much just like potato, like your breakfast potato. What's the word I'm looking for?
Big cubes.
Your big cubes of potato. But I think they were like deep fried. Because some of them were really, really crispy. But, the tartar sauce was good. I think it was made in-house. It was a fair meal, but overpriced for what it was, I think.
Yes.
Very, very much so.
I agree.
But they did have 1919 root beer on tap, so that's always a nice touch. Mm-hmm. Which I'm sure was like a $6 glass of root beer or something.
I think it was like $4.50 or something.
Okay. Yeah. That's a little bit.
My coffee, I think, was $2.50 or $3.50.
Oh, good Lord.
That lousy coffee, yeah. My quick trip frappe thing here is a million times better than that. Dang.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then we walked across the street to this cute little gift gift shop. The lady in there was nice.
Yeah, because we walked in and I didn't even see what you were looking at right away. The ice cream cone.
Oh yeah, yeah. She had a fake. It was like a resin ice cream cone. Like someone dropped ice cream cone on a chair and it was melting. But it's like a fake one. And I'm almost like, oh no. And it's just, I'm like, do you know? And she's like, yeah, I know about that. And then she goes, pick it up. And I picked it. I'm like, oh, so it like looks like a melted ice cream, but it's fake. So like the dog poo thing, only with ice cream. And so, yeah. And then, so yeah, so then we kind of walked around a little bit. She was chatting with people. And then I looked at a ring that was made with kind of like a ground down piece of basin, the blue, old blue basin jars. It was a piece of glass from one of those, and they ground it down into like this, like,
gem
kind of thing. Yeah, and put it on, glued it or something to a ring. But, and then I saw, as I looked up from that, I saw these cool bracelets, and this one is, I forgot what it is now, I'll have to put it, but it's made out of, you know, natural stones, like polished and handmade and stuff. And so yeah, it was.
And fits your wrist.
And it fits my wrist.
Which is surprising because she has very, very little wrist, so she has a hard time finding bracelets to fit.
Yeah, just plop off.
Yeah, so when, you know, she tried it on and slipped it on, it's like, oh yeah, that fits perfectly. Yeah, we have to get that. There was a discussion with the nice lady, again, whose name we didn't get, about pants, because she was commenting that this one is wearing shorts.
Yep.
And it's like 50 degrees in two harbors. So, and she was like, what? And she was like, oh yeah, we just went down the thing and she was like, really, today? And I'm like, yeah, like 2 hours ago. And she was like, what? How are you still walking? It's like,
barely.
It was
freezing to death.
So then there was, you know, talking about where to get pants in Two Harbors. And it's like, there's pretty much nowhere to get pants in Two Harbors.
One place she told us to try, but then I couldn't find it.
And yeah, we had trouble finding it. And I think I got that confused with one of the coffee places she was talking about. Because you had mentioned that the coffee across the street stunk. Yeah. And she's like, oh, I never got coffee over there. And you're like, yeah, don't. Yeah.
Just go without the coffee.
Yeah, and then the woman's job brought up a couple other places to get coffee. Anyway, it was a whole thing. But it was nice. It was, you know, one of those, like I had slight reservations. Because, I mean, I've seen places like that before, and they're usually kind of whatever. But that immediate connection that you guys had,
yeah,
like immediately put everything at ease. It's like, okay, this is cool. We can hang. Plus, it was nice and warm in there.
Oh,
it was so very, very nice.
Man, I almost asked for a job just so I could stay in there longer. She's like, okay, go dust this stuff or something.
You'd be like, okay.
Yeah. And then we roamed on down the line.
Yeah, and then we made our way to the panel, and you saw the tastings that we did there. And yes, we did go with the growler of the campfire. Though right before we were leaving, we saw them put up two other new signs of other available ones. And we're like, oh, okay. So we sampled those, and one was a prickly pear.
Which were lagers.
Well, and they were both light lagers. And the prickly pear was okay. It was very light, with just like a hint of the sweetness of the pear.
Well, prickly pear is actually a cactus.
Oh, right, yeah.
So, at least as far as I know. So it's a succulent.
I'm pretty sure, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so it's kind of like that slightly, pretty much nothing, almost like aloe, but the little thing of like that polished taste, like, yeah. So, but it was not much. There was not much to be had there.
Yeah, not much flavor at all. And then the other one was a forget what they called it, but it was basically like a
Arnie Palmer, or was it Arnie something? Arnie Paddler or something?
It had some sort of clever name, but it was essentially Arnie Palmer, which is half tea, half lemonade.
Yeah.
That one is pretty good. Like, I probably could have had like a pint of that.
He actually did ask about getting it for the growler, but...
Yeah, but since those two, the new ones, were cask ones, they only make a certain amount, so those you can't get in the growler. So we got a growler of the campfire, which I'm going to try to do something a little crazy with, and beer purist... You know, don't come at me.
But it's not your beer. It's our beer. So
yes. Because the last kind of couple sips of it, I picked up some like cherry notes, and I was like, because I last trip we did to Total Wine, I finally picked up a jar of the actual imported like maraschino cherries, like the fancy ones, and haven't cracked them open yet. And I'm like, take a couple of those, throw it in there, a little bit of the cherry juice, and then you suggested to muddle it. And I'm like, that might be better. So yeah, we're going to try that when you get out, and we'll pour back and see how that is. Because I'm looking to get this growler going. Because I'm not going to drink more than, I'm not going to be drinking it like 20 ounces at a time. So it's going to take me a while to get through. So if I could find some other way to kind of enhance it, I guess would be the proper word. Then,
I could probably do that in a barbecue, like kind of a barbecue sauce. Barbecue sauce too.
Maybe
send you some of that now. Maybe we might have to twinkle around with that tomorrow. Maybe for the heck of it, maybe we'll have to go get like a ribs or something and make like a, or even some chicken fingers or something and make like a barbecue sauce. Some chicken breast, we can make some homemade chicken fingers.
I may have chicken. I know I have all the pork chops that you gave me, too.
Oh, we can make some pork fingers or something. Pork
fingers, yeah.
Yeah.
And then take a little bit of that and, like, cook it down to, like, a syrup and...
Make barbecue out of it. Yeah, we could do that.
See, now the mind's just going.
Make some good coleslaw, because, did you tell them about your blend is coleslaw on the planet?
It developed more in the mouth a little bit.
A little.
But initially, I'm like, this is basically just cabbage. And they must have gotten to the end of the head of cabbage, because it was literally like... A big chunk, like a hand of cabbage in this little itty-bitty
remnant. At you.
It was basically just cabbage, mayo, and the tiniest amount of black pepper. Like, that was it. It was literally the blandest coleslaw I've ever had in my life.
At Blackwoods, yeah.
At Blackwoods, yeah.
ADD problem over here. Mm-hmm. And then at Ben Paddle, they had a food truck there. And the food truck's name... UpDawg,
yes.
Yeah, it was a hot dog food truck.
And I saw somewhere, and it was tropical... versions of hot dogs.
I didn't know that. I would have had to try something. I mean, obviously I didn't need it, but I would have had to try. So you know me, I would have had to try something.
Oh yeah.
I didn't know they were tropical.
I think that's what it's.
I thought tropical had to do with something else. I didn't know that was pertaining to the hot dogs.
We will have to look that up. We'll have to research that.
Okay.
Yeah, and then, again, just as we were leaving, they were gearing up, because they have live music on the weekends, so they were gearing up for whoever was coming in.
Nick and Stella or something, I don't know.
Kate, somebody, yeah. It was like a duo, probably like an acoustic duo.
Someone and someone, Isles.
Yeah. But, I mean, they have a really good setup there, really nice stage for a brewery, like... Nicest stage I've seen at a brewery, actually. So that was kind of cool. And they have, like, house lights and PA, it looked like. And put the curtain up and put a little sign with the, what was it, Cosmo?
decent. You know, they weren't overly chatty, but they were
very clean.
I saw them wiping everything all the time.
Oh, yeah. They were very, very, very clean.
And nice. And you're not supposed to get the growler of the campfire. So don't show up telling them that you heard us talking about it. You're supposed to show up and get it. It was because our growler was a specialty charity one from the
mental auction.
Health show thing. And that's the only reason that he was like, oh, yeah, no, go ahead. And fine, I'm not supposed to, but I'll do it for you.
Unless he was like, it was some sort of weird joke that we weren't in on.
Oh, I don't know.
Which I don't know. I mean, yeah.
Because it did say their limited release ones are not allowed in the growlers.
Oh.
But this one didn't say limited. It just said specialty.
Yeah, it was marked as a specialty,
Which
cost it more.
But it didn't tell us you could only get this or this or this in the growler. It just said three fills is all it said.
Yeah,
so
just three fills.
But, I mean, if worst to worst, I would have been like, here's your extra $4. Like, let us just...
Yeah, I mean, we totally would have paid for it. Yeah, that's not an issue at all. But
I mean, he was nice. He's like, and then you were like, but it's for a charity. And then he's like,
And I mean, that being said, the woman that helped us at Castlevania was really nice too.
She was really nice.
Yeah, we've had, in all the breweries we've been to up here, we've always had, all the staff has always been really, really nice and helpful. And, yeah.
We actually decided that a new job for him is he can pour beer. Mm-hmm. So that's because we like, oh, what could be his new job? Like, you could pour beer. And then I'm like, I could do like, it was an eagle up there. And then I'm like, I could do the coffee for this. Because we noticed that they have, the 1919 or the Bent Paddle had like their own specialty root beer, you know, non-alcoholic. And they actually had a nitro coffee for one of the local coffee companies. Mm-hmm. And they also had a version of their coffee stout as non-alcoholic for the non-alcoholic, for people who didn't want alcohol. But I'm like, but they don't have like a coffee bar in there, you know? So I'm like, I could do a coffee bar, and then we can have like food and munchies in the middle, and then we can have beer on the other side. Mm-hmm. So we're like, well, geez, our dreams of finding different jobs is just escalating.
Yeah, it's yeah.
I would want to own it. I mean, I would work there, but I wouldn't want to have to own it and
no, because that
be
yeah,
responsible
that, that's
for
a
all
lot
of
like yeah. I wouldn't even want to be like a partner in it. I just hire us. Yeah,
so just hire us, guys. If anybody's looking for, I mean, that if you're gonna pay us like more than we're worth, I'm sure. Because you know, it's our idea.
So. Well, I was gonna say between the job ideas we're having and the house ideas we're having for once we do combine forces,
yeah,
we're gonna need something because our house is gonna be cool, but it's gonna be pricey.
Yep, because we both do like nice things in life, and food and beer and music and comfort, creature comforts.
Oh yeah, we are such creatures of creature comforts. Yes. But yeah. So it was a shorter trip.
Yeah.
But still a good trip.
So we're going home Saturday evening.
Yeah, it's still Saturday.
Yeah. At least we won't have to fight that traffic tomorrow.
Won't have to fight traffic tomorrow. We didn't have to pay for another night at the hotel.
It's freaking cold up here.
Plus, it is freaking cold up here.
It's and like now it's finally 61, and we still have another hour.
Yeah, we're just under 95 miles away. So we're about halfway there, roughly.
Whoa.
A little less than that. So that was the trip. All in all, very, very good. I had a good time.
Yeah.
You had a good time.
Other than swearing at people in my sleep again last night, but that just happens.
That just happens. So, yeah.
Yeah, no, was a very nice little trip, nice little break. Some music, nice people to talk to, good beers to taste, and
yeah, this trip is, I mean, because of the growler from Head Paddle and because of the craft tapped.
Yeah.
It was a lot more beer centric than our trips usually are, but that's okay. You know, because as I say, you only live once, and might as well enjoy it while you can. So yeah, we will try our little beer tail. Beer tail? Is that what it would be? Beer cocktail? Beer tail?
Beer tail, sure. Or I think instead of a mojito, it's a cherrito or cherrito. I don't know.
Cherry. Anyway.
Chair beer.
When we get around to that, we'll let you know how that is. But until then, and I never do this on my videos, and everybody else does, so thank you for watching. Thank you to my 105 subscribers.
Yay!
I don't know who you are, but, yeah. You know, I mean, I know who some of you are. Mm-hmm. And yeah, thank you for coming on this journey with us. And let us know if you like this kind of more, you know, traditional vlogging style of a video. Because if this works out, I mean, if I put it together and it looks good, I might, well, probably do this kind of style for Rockfest.
Okay.
Because that would just be easier than, A, trying to remember everything, like, 2 days later. And then we have a tendency to talk anyway, so it'd be sorting through, like, you know, 5 hours of footage to do all that. So and doing it, you know, as soon after the event as we can, I think is better. I mean, we still forget stuff because, you know, you do, but because we're human. But anyway. You know, do all the things. You know.
Don't be a dick.
Don't be a dick and be a nice person. Take care of people and all that. And, you know, like and subscribe and share and do all that fun stuff. And I still got the Patreon. No one's joined it yet, but if you want to jump on there and as we discussed earlier in this video, We should do a what's it, bracket?
Reverse.
A reverse or kind of a what would that be, like a mega Patreon? Would that be the like cool hip game you're turning up for it?
I'm not cool nor hip, so I don't really know.
nor a gamer. So
Tetris is about all I do.
So most Patreons give you, you know, full episodes of their videos, you know, without commercials, and none of my stuff is monetized anyway, so that doesn't matter. Or behind the scenes stuff, or like, whatever. So, since our videos have a tendency of being longer, because we like to ramble, join our Patreon, and you'll get like the short, like, Reader's Digest version of our videos. You'll get like the Reels version or the TikTok version or whatever, you know, thing you want to do. So if you want to, I'll throw the Patreon link in here. And, you know, if you like, you know, join up, you can. But other than that, thank you for joining us, and hope you have an excellent rest of the weekend. Even though I probably won't post this till after the weekend, but whatever. You know, it is what it is. Mm-hmm. So, any last words?
Last words? No. Bye!
Other than you should go visit Duluth because it's awesome.
Drink your beer, drink your coffee, listen to your music, be nice to everybody that doesn't deserve a shanking, and, just...
And support all your locals and buy that merch.
Buy the merch.
Yeah. Alright. I'll talk to you later. Sweet girl, caught between a conversation.